Hey guys, what's going on? It's your boy, SevGamer, and I'm back with some more Might and Magic Elemental Guardians. And today, I just want to give all the new players, and a lot of you are new right now, I want to give all the new players just something, some quick info on where to farm and what to do to farm up your creatures really quickly. Alright, and the first thing you want to do is you want to find a farmer, okay? I'm going to show you the farmer I use, but a lot of people that probably did not get any lightning on their soul stones probably want to use this two-star unit here. I'm sure a lot of people could get him. Where is he at? I must be passing him. All right. There he goes. No. Not Rune Guardian. They look similar. There he goes. Alright, the Stone Guard. Any element of the Stone Guard, you can use to farm. So if you get this guy, don't let this guy go. Of course, if you get a 3-star unit, that's better. Go ahead and do that. But the reason they're all good is you want to get whatever farmer you want to get. You want to try to get vampire shit really quickly. I'm going to show you where to go to get the vampire equipment, okay? You don't have to have the best vampire equipment and to start off, but you just want to be able to use something that can farm and that can constantly heal themselves. Alright, and the reason they're good is like things like this. It has a 50% chance to counterattack anybody that hits him. Alright, so the good thing about this is he's going to keep on hitting you back and healing with his vampire. Plus, when you attack on your skill, you can stay. So you just be able to sustain and survive, okay? 50% chance of retaliating. And here, you're going to be doing attacks based on your HP, alright? So he's very tanky, he can do damage based on his HP, plus he counterattacks every time somebody tries to crit on him, so he counterattacks, and you can heal yourself once again, alright? And then, right now it's just the basic skill. When you evolve him, it gains a skill. I guess we could look at what skill he gains. A lot of people use the water one right here. See, he counterattacks. He also puts a shield on himself, so gives him more survivability. All right, and then right here, attacks all enemies inflicting great damage with attack increase based on HP again. All right, and then the air defender also is good. He attacks all enemies increase based on his defense. He regenerates for 2 turns, so he's gonna heal himself for 20% of his HP for 2 turns. All right. On top of him having vampire will give him that survivability that you need to have a farmer, and plus he'll be doing damage based on his defense. So he's tanky enough. Alright. And this is probably the best one to farm with. Attacks all enemies and drains their HP by 25%. Alright. And what's this skill right here? Attacks all enemies with an attack increase based on his HP. Alright, he ties it for 2 turns and lowers their turn bar. So you'll be getting more turns, lowering their turn bar. You'll be draining their HP. And of course, having him with vampire set would be good. Now I'm going to show you the farmer I use. Okay? So I was doing my summons until I could get... I was spamming these epic soul stones. I was mainly trying to find a farmer. Of course I wanted a 4-star. I wanted to see if I could get a 4-star, but I wanted to see if I could get somebody that could be a good farmer. And it turns out I found a very good farmer in the Kabuki Ninja. I believe he's called the Kabuki Ninja. Alright, let's go to him real quick. Alright, I know he's called Mountain Ninja when he evolves. But I believe... I got the Fire Kabuki Ninja and I got the... Yeah, so it is the Kabuki Ninja. Alright, so I'm using the wood one. Alright, the reason the wood one is so good is because he procs so many times. Every time he attacks, he has a 40% chance of recovering his turn. Alright, so it's a high proc rate. Sometimes he procs 4 times in a row. Alright. Typically it's 2 times, but sometimes he can go all the way to 4. Every now and then 4. Sometimes 3. But usually it's he procs twice every turn. Alright. Tax all enemies and decrease their critical chance for one turn, so he stopped them from doing major damage to him. And well, this guy I'm gonna show you, but he could put them to sleep. I actually evolved mine, as you can see. So I evolved mine to Mountain Ninja, and he could actually put them to sleep, which also is very good for farming. All right, he has that crowd control element to him. All right, so if you get a Kabuki Ninja, go ahead and get him on a Vampire Lifesteal set. All right, so I got my guy here. You see his HP, not the best HP. Attack is around like 2700. Speed, I could get that way better for farming. But since he procs so much, it hasn't been a hindrance at all. I'll show you that. We're gonna test him out and show you. All right, and we got attack. This is flat stats right now. All right, it's definitely beginning the game. Flat stats are better than percentage. But as you grow, as you progress, you want to start changing out those flat stats with percentage stats. All right, so we have attack. So I got him on attack and lifesteal set. All right, we got HP here, we got crit, we got HP, and we got attack. So I got three glyphs with attack on it. All right, I got one with HP for a little bit of survivability. I got him critting. I want him to crit a little bit more often, and then so we got two HP. Or I got three attacks, two HP, one crit on him on an attack and lifesteal set. All right. And you saw my stats for him. I'm jumping rope right now. All right. But yeah, so these are my basic stats. Not a lot of speed. Decent attack on him. And so I guess it's okay HP. All right. Now, you're like, where do I get the lifesteal? Early on, you want to get the lifesteal from the Dragon Mist Islands. But you could get it from the Wastelands if you could get far enough. I wouldn't suggest trying. It's going to be pretty hard. Fire Maze is pretty hard, okay? So, Wastelands does drop lifesteal, okay? But it's easier starting off to go to Dragon Mist and just go to the Glyph Dungeon and farm probably stage 2 of Wrath. If you can't get the... So you see, I'm mostly farming 3. I just farmed 3. But farming 2 or 1 at the wherever you're at in your level, they all will drop your lifesteal sets that you need. And you just need the basic lifesteal sets. Like I said, you don't need a crazy percentage, and you don't need like an epic soul stone. You can use common and uncommons, and it'll get your job done. All right. So whatever damage dealer you're using, that probably got the proc a lot, has AOE skills, or like has some way of healing themselves. With vampire, that's a farmer you want to use. Now, once you found your farmer, okay. You want to be able to pick a good place to farm, and the best place to farm definitely early on is Nightmare on the Floating Islands. Okay, first stage. That's the best place to farm. I was doing a comparison to other places further down. Of course, if you could farm the last stage on Legend, on Nightmare. Of course that would be very good, but we're talking about early game. Try to do this as fast as possible, get through Floating Island, and try to get to Nightmare and get to stage 1 with your farmer. Once you get the Nightmare with your farmer, all right, so you see I've been farming, so I got this one up to max now. I actually just got him up to max. All right, so I want to get this guy up. No, actually, we just got a newer. We just got this unit. You just saw this last video. All right. So this is one I got him right here. I got him with my, I think it was a legendary soul stone. All right. He's, the more I look at him, he's pretty good. I was just mad. I really wanted 4-star. All right. So y'all remember last video. I was looking all depressed when I got him. But we're going to go ahead and farm. I'm going to show you. The keys to it is you want to be able to farm quickly. You want to be able to gain that XP. And the cool thing about farming in the Nightmare stage, you can find epic glyphs. Alright? And those epic glyphs do definitely come in handy. Alright, so you see he attacked twice. And Kabuki did put him to sleep. Alright, so once again, he just proc twice again. So it's very good. If y'all have a Kabuki Ninja, definitely focus on using him as a farmer. Right now, he's my main carry. I use him everywhere. I use him in arena right now. So that's typically what happens in the beginning of the game. Your farmer is the person you use pretty much everywhere. But the cool thing about this is you can get very good glyphs. And the glyphs you don't want to use, you can make a lot of money. All right. And you can level up your other creatures very quickly. Alright, so let's see if he procs again here. Let's see if Kabuki Ninja procs again. Nope, he didn't proc. But that's all good. He did get the... He typically lands that. I haven't seen him really resist that, but reduces their crit rate on him. Alright, put him to sleep. So that really comes in handy, that AoE. I mean, that crowd control skill really comes in handy. And there you go, 2500 XP on that single character. You can level up whatever creature you want to very quickly. Definitely when you want to start ranking them up to the next level. All right, so he really comes in handy. So basically, guys, find a farmer. I sold you a couple of 2-star farmers you can get. I'm sure there's other 3-star farmers out there. Other than the Kabuki Ninja. Actually, you know, there is another one right here. This guy right here could be a farmer too. If you have the Air Basilisk. Okay. This skill right here is really good. The only thing with him, you have to get crit rate. You have to be able to get crit rate. So if you could find Vampire and crit rate, that's why I showed you the other ones. They're easier to glyph. But if you could find good glyphs for him, he could be really good. I'll use him real quick and show y'all. If attack is critical, steal 70% of their turn bar and poison them for 2 turns. All right, so that's his passive. So he's gonna steal their turn bar as long as you crit. And you see, I got his crit right now at 104%. So it's overkill on the crit. All right, and then he also can attack and then dodge for 2 turns, which is gonna be very useful for farming. All right, and then if we upgrade him. I believe he poisons on his first skill. Attacks enemy increases self speed for 1 turn. No. Attacks enemy increases attack damage based on your speed. Oh, no. So he doesn't poison on his first skill. That would have been, I guess, a little OP for him. But he attacks enemy increases based on his speed, or he can boost his speed. So this could be a very good farmer for you guys. And you see, if you get a Kabuki Ninja, I got lucky and I got the one that... it's not showing me what it is. Actually, I could use my other Kabuki Ninja. I think he blocks beneficial effects, or you could put to sleep. So I was hoping I got the one that puts him to sleep from my farmer, and it did work. Let's see. Yeah, preventing him from getting a beneficial effect for 1 turn. All right. So with him, I hope I also get the sleep skill. So I ended up getting 2 Kabuki Ninjas. So they're very good, guys. Very good farmers. I just tried to show you some alternative just in case you didn't have getting lightning and get a 3-star. Y'all have you got a 2-star to look at. But I'm gonna show you this Basilisk real quick, all right, and then we'll go ahead and wrap it up. We'll bring him in. Instead of autoing, I'll just show you what he can do. So we'll take him into the same place. Nightmare Floating Island, stage 1. And I'm going to bring in my Air Basilisk. All right. So hopefully that's helpful for you guys. It's really to progress quickly in this game. You need a farmer. All right. I was too late taking out the auto, but it's all good. All right. So now we're going to show you his skill. Let's take... Alright, so we poisoned him, but he resisted the bar being stolen. But we did poison him on that move, and then we did get, you see he just missed. You saw that? So he could be a very good farmer for you. Now let's see if he could steal that. All right, so he steals that turn bar, and he poisons him. So he's gonna, it's almost like he's proccing, which is very good. All right, I steal his turn bar again. So he's never, if I keep on stealing his turn bar, he doesn't resist it. Plus, I'm poisoning. You see how many poisons we land? And you see how many times we done stole his turn bar? He's about to go again. All right, this could be a very good two-star farmer. All right, just letting you know, I'm just letting you know, there's two-star farmers out there. You don't have to have a Kabuki Ninja like I do, but look at this. Ah, he didn't steal it. There is a chance that they resist, okay? There is a chance of resisting. But when I do that move, let's see if they... Oh, he didn't miss that time. Didn't miss that time. We're going to take his attack bar. He has the most... All right, so... All right, we get the move again. Let's see if we can we take his attack bar again. Yes, we can. Plus, we poison him. Let's take his attack bar again. Yes, and we poison him again. We're going to go again. And imagine having him really, really fast. I don't even have him at the, on haste or anything like that. All right. Now, once again, let's see if we can take the boss's attack bar. Nope. We couldn't take it. But I don't have him on vampire, so he's not healing, guys. And he's only like level 6 right now. But you can see as a farmer how he could be very useful for you guys. Okay? Alright, so just in case there's people that probably didn't make it to the end of this video, I'll do a video just on Basilisk alone and so on him. Because I could see him useful everywhere. Alright, that's one of those guys that, one of those two stars that I think needs a spotlight video and needs to be shown to everybody. Alright, just in case they just overlooking them, because you know everybody really wants a 4-star and really look at those 3-stars, but I actually built him before a couple of 3-stars I've gotten. Alright, so Basilisk is a very, very, very good creature to have. Alright guys, so hopefully that was helpful. I just, let me summarize. Find a farmer one, okay, I just gave you a whole bunch of the farmers you could get. Find Vampire Gliss for him, alright. Beat the floating island until you can get to legendary, and then do the first stage and use your farmer, and that 2500 XP will quickly level up anybody you need to start ranking up your heroes to get into four star or 5-star to get later on in content in the game. Alright, so hopefully that was helpful, guys. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Until next time, this is your boy 7Gamer, and I'm out. Peace, guys. Wanna be my father, I don't ever want to leave. I'm in a